people to our coastal communities to eat and shop. Miriam Dotson is with us this morning, getting us more on this effort. Miriam, thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having me. It's good to see you. It's good to be here with all of you.
I love this effort. You know, we've heard from some of the restaurants and business owners that as they're working to climb back, mm-hmm. they're not seeing maybe the traffic that we had hoped from our local community to support them.
Yeah, and you know, when we talk about this Savor the Shore effort, it's really an effort from the Visitor and Convention Bureau, as you mentioned, the VCB, county leadership, mm-hmm. hospitality industry, and business leaders who realized, you know, summer is typically the slower season anyway,
sure.
as we kind of know that here, as the resident sees a little bit slower traffic and all that.
Right.
But post-Ian, as we can imagine, it has been definitely a little bit worse mm-hmm. because people are waiting for hotels to come back up and open.
Right.
People are confused on what's going on. So we've been trying to send the message out of the area for visitors to know where we stand, mm-hmm. you know, as a tourism community. But our residents have to play a part in that role, too. And I think it's important that they know the role they play in this rebuilding.
Mm-hmm.
And part of that is going out and visiting a shop that just opened. These restaurants rushed to get open, especially on the coastal communities. And we don't want to leave out any inland properties
of
and
course,
the city of Fort Myers and all that. But particularly, you know, Sanibel, Fort Myers Beach, Captiva, Pine Island, Matlache, you know, all of these beloved areas. And these restaurateurs are rushing, all working together. And then now it is a little bit of a lull. And again, typically in the summer it would be. But we really want to send the message to the resident of how important they are in all of this. And, of course, with respect to residents having their own issues to deal with at the same time post-Ian.
Of course. You know, it's interesting. I've spoken to some of the restaurant owners, and they're frustrated, to put it mildly, because they're saying, you know, some of their friends haven't even come to their restaurant because it's too depressing on the beach.
Or,
you know, that's if you haven't been out there, I can speak from my own experience, that is not the case.
Right.
It's actually, I think, inspiring to see what people are doing and the grit of Southwest Florida as we're climbing back.
Yeah, and as I've gone out to go meet with a lot of the restaurateurs too, I mean, when you're having a bad day and you're like, oh, I'm going to go, I leave there so inspired. It gives me chills just thinking about it. Folks that we've talked to, you know, Wahoo Willie's on Fort Myers Beach.
Great
as you just mentioned, Crow's Nest is opening on Captiva. Mm-hmm. RC Otter's opened last week. Doc Ford's on Fort Myers Beach is opening today.
That's
wonderful. These are hardworking people who are ready to go, and we want those jobs to stay here. We want the server to go back to work and get that fully staffed. We want everybody to go down there and enjoy it. And when we talk about that heartbreaking, it is. And that's okay. You're human. You feel terrible about what's happened.
But it doesn't look the same.
It doesn't. Right.
Yeah.
Parts of it, though, are beautiful. The beaches on Fort Myers Beach,
mm-hmm.
you know, every beach on Sanibel is open.
Right.
So you can go there. And a lot of those restaurants are at full capacity. I mean, some of them have adjusted or they maybe have a food truck. But we're not talking about just a couple of restaurants. I mean, there's dozens on each of those islands that are open. And you know, Jen, we talked about it, too. It's like, it's so heartbreaking. I don't want to see it. Well, this is the time where we need you to kind of go down and just support it and support the people and rally around each other as a community to help. And just going out and having a dessert. If you can't do full
make
dinner,
a difference.
Get a drink, you know, and just go enjoy the view. The sunset hasn't changed.
So. It's going to be even more heartbreaking if these people, if our entrepreneurs have fought back.
Right.
And then they shut down
because
we haven't been supporting them.
Right. And then it's crickets and it's us all going, oh, I want to survive. But yeah, I didn't really make the effort to go out there. And, you know, we understand that. I also want to point that out. I think everybody watching right now has some issue that they're dealing with due to this storm. We know money is an issue for everybody, right?
Yeah.
We talk about that a lot. But if you can find just a little bit of time, even if you're just going down, like I said, for a drink, bring the kids. You know, they're all kid friendly or family friendly to some capacity.
What is Savor Our Shore? What exactly does this initiative consist of?
Yeah, so typically the VCB attracts visitors from out of the area,
which
is why a lot of our residents are kind of like, what is the Visitor and Convention Bureau? You know, so we put a lot of our marketing efforts to get people to come into the area to then collect bed tax and make our life a lot better, right?
Sure.
So
right.
That's the point of it. In this case, Savor Our Shore really is to tell the resident, it's ours too, and it's yours, and I want you to enjoy it, and you should be able to take advantage of where you live and the beauty that is there, and right now is the perfect time to do it. So I keep saying, you know, summer is typically slow. I mean, some businesses in the past would say, hey, we're going to have our week vacation now and shut down just to give our team a break. But this is really an initiative that we want to see go on forever. There's no end date. But you will see local ads, radio ads, TV ads, things like this that you're seeing on your screen right now.
I love the graphic. That's great.
Yeah, isn't it pretty? Doesn't it look good? Don't you want to take a bite out of that, right?
It looks fantastic.
SavorTheShore.com, too, is where we have some more information for people to take a look at that. These ads that are what we would call locally, put in our local area, mm-hmm. will run throughout the summer.
Okay.
But we don't want to put an expiration date on when to go support your local mm-hmm. restaurants. And while we're focusing on restaurants, you know, it is also the gift shops
sure.
and the shops that have popped up. You know, when you go to Sanibel, Crow is open. Mm-hmm. You know, Ding Darling is open.
Right.
Those places are open as well. And it's just good to go out there. But these restaurateurs, I really feel like the rush and the what they put in to get them open mm-hmm. Is just remarkable. And even if you just go down there and meet them and talk to them, they would appreciate
right.
that, I think, to hear their story and how important the resident is and how important the restaurants are as well.
We all need to play a part in it. You know, we want the
yeah.
community to come back. And so that's why we're partnering. I love that we're doing this. And mm-hmm. we're going to be bringing some restaurants and some businesses on this show to help
yeah.
promote them as well. And we all need to do our part, right? I mean, let's not make it more depressing.
Exactly.
Let's encourage and inspire our friends and neighbors. I think,
exactly.
You know, we were speaking. We've been all over the place.
Mm-hmm.
Part of it is our jobs, but I can attest. It's really nice. You know,
yeah.
people have come back. It's not depressing. Please,
right.
please go out.
And they're not depressing people. I have to
yeah.
say, my goodness, if you want to find the hardest working, strongest, most amazing people,
yeah.
go out to those beaches today if you can. You know, and I know school is starting soon. We've
sure.
got kids. I understand. We've got the sports and everything going on, and a lot of it does not take you to the coast in that way. But
mm-hmm.
if you can, go out there and really, they want to hear from you too.
They
know,
do.
Introduce yourself and talk to them, and you will leave there more inspired, I promise, than depressed. So
I love
it's
this.
Really out there.
Well, we'll put a link to Savor Our Shore on our website as well. You'll be seeing more and more of these restaurants and businesses coming in here as well, so we can try to give them some publicity
yes.
and remind you about what wonderful resources and people
yeah.
we have here.
Yeah.
Miriam, thank you so
yes,
much.
Thank you so much for having us.
We